Some bad. There are no refunds. So, unfortunately, our soprano, Sarah Frank, became ill rather suddenly with a cold, and she started losing her voice. So she is not here today, but the good news is we are still going to be performing almost all the songs in the program, and I will talk you through that. So if you don't have a program, now is your time to quick run and grab one. There are plenty left, I'm sure. The first announcement is that Tabitha Steggy, a soprano who Maggie knows and we all love, she is a senior at UW-Milwaukee right now. She is going to be stepping in and performing the seventh piece on the program, Romance de Mignon. The first piece, actually, we are omitting. So we're going to start with the Manoir de Rosemont and continue through there with Tabitha singing Romance de Mignon. And then two pieces later, La Fuite, that was our duet, that is also being omitted. And in its place, you'll see two songs later, Extase, Ecstasy or Rapture. We're gonna put that in the place of La Fuite, so we're just moving that one up by two. Otherwise, the rest of the program is as indicated, but I will be singing two of Sarah Frank's songs, so my apologies for that. Oh yes!
They said there would be no math.
So once more for all of you, the first piece is omitted, unfortunately. So we will be beginning with the second piece, Le Manoir de Rosemont. Then after Kristen Danino sings Elegy, we have a different soprano, Tabitha Steggy, singing Romance de Mignon. Then our other tenor, Cameron Smith, is going to sing L'Invitation. It's not my song, so. L'Invitation au Voyage. And then the next song, a duet, La Fuite, is omitted. At that time, however, I will sing Extase, which is actually in your programs two songs later, followed by Serenade Florentine, and then you'll get to hear me again on Fidile. If that's a little confusing, all will become clear over the course of the program. There are translations for you, so that even though it's all in French, it won't be all Greek to you. And after the translations, there are some biographies, artist bios, in the back. And then a little bit of information about Culavoce. So you are here today on the at the Grace Lutheran Church First Friday's concert series, but it's also a Culavoce concert series. And you can read more about Culavoce and their upcoming concerts here and on the back page, the upcoming concerts on the First Friday series, which is always right here on the first Friday of every month. So I hope that informs you and gets you ready for the concert. We will begin with the Manoir de Rosemont.
Thank you. Thank you.
basket on the way back. If you feel like you have overpaid, like I said before, no refunds. But by way of apology, and for everyone else as well, we have some cookies and punch afterwards, so you can feel free to stick around and talk with the artists and each other and do whatever you do around cookies and punch. I also wanted to just give a special thank you to Maggie for organizing the concert and for doing all the hard work of putting these together and practicing it and organizing it. For those of you who haven't read yet, Cola Voce basically is Megan Reavers. If you see that name, you know there's going to be quality associated with it. So if you see it in the future, do yourself a favor and bring as many people as you can to more Cola Voce concerts. With that, we will end the program with Duparc's most famous piece. I will try my best to not let you down, with Chanson Triste.